The following opinions are solely those of BoatTEST.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTEST.com, and today I'm going to be discussing the topic of weather and how to get it into your hands. For me, the best way to do it is with a SiriusXM weather subscription displayed right on my chart plotter. Now, here's the thing. All of the chart plotter manufacturers have their own interface for SiriusXM, but they all operate a little bit differently, so today we're going to discuss how it works with a Garmin unit. First of all, I get it. You ask anybody what the weather's going to be, and what do? Pull out their cell phones. The big question is that going to be good enough for everyone? In my opinion, no. No, it's not. There are several weather apps, and they all do a little bit of components of what we need, but SiriusXM does it all in one service. Also, your apps need to be continually refreshed, so you always have to be within cellular range. You get away from the dock, suddenly you're not getting current information, and you're not getting accurate information. But most importantly, do you really want to be cruising along at 30 knots and have to pull out your phone and look at what's going on? For me, absolutely not. I want to look at the information right on the display that I'm already looking at, and that is where SiriusXM comes in. When you put a SiriusXM receiver on your boat, the first thing you're going to want to do is activate it. You need your SiriusXM ID number. Garmin calls it the radio ID. To locate the radio ID, from the home screen, press Settings, System, System Information, Software Information. This will bring up a screen that shows your MFD model number and, if the weather receiver is correctly installed, your SiriusXM radio ID number. Once your receiver has been activated, select Charts from the list on the right of the home page, and you should now have four SiriusXM related buttons. Let's start with the precipitation button. This shows rain, freezing rain, snow, etc. All the shades of green, yellow, and red. The colors vary depending on the intensity and type of precipitation. If we press Menu at the bottom of the screen, we can select many other features to customize the current screen to show almost any layer of information we want simultaneously. Let's briefly go through all of the button functions in this menu. The first button will show is either Observe Layers or Forecast Layers, depending on the settings of the button number 2. Tapping this button will bring up the list of various weather layers one can choose. Layer Mode allows you to toggle between Observed and Forecast. Observed is the term for the current conditions. Forecast is for viewing what conditions are expected to be coming at a defined point in the future. Loop shows a running image of the weather so you can see trends, which way the precipitation is going. Don't leave this on though, because you'll easily confuse it with what's happening now with what happened previously. Everyone does. And to be clear, this is satellite based, not GPS based, not cellular. You get a couple miles offshore and down to 2 bars, the animation feature on your cell phone won't be working. Legend allows you to turn on and off a window to the left of the screen that provides details about data layers that are displayed. Weather subscription, we'll get more into that later. Restore defaults resets the weather layers shown on the chart to the standard selection of data elements for a given weather page selected from the home screen. If you goof up, here's how to put it all back together and get it right back the way it was. Edit overlays allows you to add, remove, and edit different windows on the screen that can show navigational information such as speed, heading, media controls, engine data, etc. Now, let's return to the top of this list and talk about weather. With the second layer mode button set to Observed, tap the top button for Observed Layers. It gives you choices for current conditions. Since we had selected precipitation from the home screen, we're going to set up just for that. We'll start with the Storm button. Notice when selected, there's an indicator for a submenu. It gives you choices for 4 different pieces of information. I want radar and lightning turned on, so I tap on these. The green bar denotes that they're on. This will show the rain and any active lightning in the area that I'm viewing. My current GPS position is not needed for all this to work, but having this boat icon showing in my position is convenient and another feature lacking on phone apps. Clouds can be turned on, but I find it cluttering. It just changes the whole color of the screen if there's something like a complete overcast. For scattered clouds, we could use it for finding shade, and game fishermen will gravitate to that. Hurricane, I'll leave off. Now I hit the back button and I'm done with my precipitation page. We go back to the home screen and select the forecast button. This brings you to the same weather map, but allows you to select different information and layers. We could program our first screen to show this same info, but keeping your screens independent is advantageous for quick viewing of desired info. So here, we select Menu and put the Layer Mode button to Forecast. Now we tap the Forecast Layers button. Notice the list has changed a little. Only features which can be set to look ahead are available. So here are the layers I use. Wave. Note that there's a submenu here. We can show three pieces of forecast information about waves: direction, height, and period. For winds, the legend tells the tale of the wind barbs. Small barb is 5 miles per hour, large is 10, the flag is 50. Two large barbs and one small makes 25. Winds blowing toward the small circle. Surface pressure. When you're looking at surface pressure, you want to be zoomed out to get the big picture. Now it shows the warm and cold fronts, troughs, and isobars with high and low pressure areas. Zones is a really neat feature. We're all familiar with how the VHF weather broadcast works. It covers a huge area, and by the time it gets down to your area, you're distracted and you miss it, and I have to wait for it to cycle all the way around again. Zones with SiriusXM takes care of that in a neat way. With zones, you can see pale blue lines of boundary areas. Tap inside one, and then local weather at the top of the screen, then marine bulletin. Now you're seeing weather for that specific area. Now, while the zone button shows these boundaries, the fact is you can tap anywhere and do the same thing, even with the feature turned off. The button just displays the boundary lines on the chart. Warnings. With this activated, red zones will appear when there are urgent warnings issued. Touch the area, and then at the top of the screen, we touch marine warnings to get the warning in written format. Plus, there are alarm features that you can turn on so that when a severe storm pops up, a weather alert, a tone will sound, a window will pop up on the screen, and you have to acknowledge it, no ignoring it. That's a very cool feature. I hit the back button. Now to the left, we have the legend showing when we're looking ahead too. We can manually adjust the times with arrows or activate the loop and let it do that for us. Observe mode wouldn't let us do that. Now let's go back to the home screen and select Fishing, and then Menu. Here we're seeing the sea surface temperature. And this needs to be an observed format. You can't predict sea surface temperature. Sea surface temperatures use colors that range from dark blue to green, yellow, and red to indicate how water temps vary at different locations. You can tap anywhere on the chart to get a temp at that location and notice the sea surface temperature submenu. Here's what you need to know here. Resolution. Leave this in high. There's no reason not to. It doesn't eat up memory or bandwidth. If you're looking for a fish that hangs out in specific water temp range, you can manually set the scale. Lower sets the lower temp. Upper sets the upper end of the scale. This is useful for finding specific temperatures that your fish likes that you want to highlight. Auto is a quick way to set the scale if you're looking for temperature breaks. This is where the temperature changes are occurring. It resets the color scale just to the area you're zoomed in on. That's it. Just hit the back button. Notice you see other features here as before. If you want to see radar at the same time as sea surface temperature, you just tap Storm to add it to the screen. Now let's go back to the home screen and select Sea Conditions. To me, Sea Conditions means wind and waves, and we can view this in observed or forecast mode. I leave it on forecast because I can get to the Now button just by using the arrows at the legend box. We mentioned earlier that there are three pieces of wave info. Red arrows show the direction of waves, numbers show the period, and we can touch to get specific area info anywhere on the screen. The other layer that I like to keep turned on in Sea Conditions is weather stations, which adds these circular icons. NOAA maintains weather stations and buoys with sensors on board to record weather conditions. Back out of the menu screen and then touch one of these icons. A balloon pops up identifying the station and also a menu bar at the top of the screen. Tap the first button, Weather Station, at the top, and it will bring up all the information being recorded by that station. Now, it's important to know that this information isn't beamed from the weather satellite right to your boat. Human hands have to touch it, they sanitize it, prepare it for your boat, and develop the forecast as well. The sea surface temperature, that comes from satellites that pass every 6 hours, and SiriusXM updates it every hour. The wind updates every 20 minutes. Precipitation, that's radar-based, so that gets updated every 4 to 5 minutes. And lightning, that's every 2 to 3 minutes. Now, don't feel you need to memorize all of these times or any of the others that SiriusXM delivers. Remember that weather subscription button we talked about earlier? From any weather screen, you can tap Menu at the bottom of the page, then Weather Subscription. No guessing. The age of the data is shown here in minutes. When a piece of info gets refreshed, the timer resets to zero. Very useful screen right here. Now, this is a subscription service. There's a monthly fee involved, but because weather's the most important thing to have on your boat, it's easy to justify that expense. In fact, I'd be hard-pressed to find somebody that got the weather subscription and didn't get the music subscription on top of it. If you connect your stereo to the multifunction display, you can even control that stereo from the display, or do what I like to do and keep that control always at the bottom of the chart for easy access. And if you put your boat away for the winter time, you can also put the subscription away for the winter time for both weather and music, with no charge for lighting it up again. The SiriusXM satellites are aimed at North America, and the signal reaches up to 200 miles offshore. And remember, all of the major electronics manufacturers have SiriusXM compatible devices. They just look a little bit differently. This video is about how it looks on a Garmin display. And that's my full review. For BoatTEST.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.